When you're scaling your business, it's really, you're taking what's working, right? You're creating a model around it, and then you're scaling, right? So let's say you have a successful moving company. You are, you're doing really well. You're in your local market, but maybe you want to grow and expand to multiple locations. Maybe you want to franchise your business, right? Maybe you want to build it up to be able to sell it over the next, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 years and cash out. Maybe you want to get into something totally different, right? In order to do that, you have to create a model, right? And one of the fundamental principles in creating a model business is setting up your systems and your processes, all right? Because you do not want people to run your business. You want systems to run your business, and then you want the people to run those systems. But when you have systems and processes, and what I'm talking about here, I'm talking about documented procedures on how everything's done. So look at McDonald's, right? It's a perfect example. You go to a McDonald's anywhere in the world, for the most part, it's running the same way. It's running consistently. Is it because of the people? No, it's not, right? Not to take anything away from the people that are working at McDonald's, but it's not the people that are making everything run smooth. It's the processes. You've got to have the systems. You've got to build those systems, and you got to be able to put those in place. And then you get those right, the right people, and you put them in. And now you've got something that's really running. And guess what? When you've got systems that work, when you've got processes that work, you don't need as expensive of people. So any way that you want to scale, any way that you want to grow, right? If you want to, you know, build up your current company and then expand, open additional locations, right? You need to create a model, right? If you want to franchise your business, what a franchise is, when you franchise your business, what you're selling the model, right? You're telling somebody, hey, look, I'm going to give you the step-by-step of what you need to do. You just need to follow that and be successful at following exactly what I give you, and you're going to make money. That's essentially what a franchise does. Do you really want to pass down a business to your kids that's unruly, that's stressful, that they have to be there every day working to try to figure it out? Wouldn't you rather hand them a business with a model and a system of exactly how to do things, where the processes are laid out, the systems are laid out, and now they walk into something that's, you know, you, listen, you might have had, I'm sure that, you know, you've started your business and it was stressful, and maybe it's still stressful to this day, right? If you don't have the systems in place and you don't have the processes in place, I could assure you, you don't have the consistency that you want. And you know that. I don't have to tell you that. But if you're going to scale, if you're going to pass it down to your family, you've got to start thinking about implementing your systems, right? If you want to know how to do this, if you want to work with me over the next year, go to talktolouis.com. There's a link there. And, you know, fill out the application. I only take 10 people into the group. It's a small group. If you climb the wrong wall, right? Like if you have the ladder and it's on that wall and it's supposed to be on that wall, and you start putting in all this effort and you go to the totally wrong place, that's not going to be successful for you, right? So you got to establish your blueprint, number one. Then you have to get your systems in place, right? Your systems, your processes. I'm talking about in writing. I'm talking about exactly what you know, the step-by-step of how to do every process, from, you know, confirming moves, from your dispatcher confirming moves, to your accounting process, right? To what your bookkeeper needs to do step-by-step to make sure that you have an accurate profit and loss statement every single month, right? Everything needs to be documented. And this doesn't happen overnight, but you've got to start, right? Then next thing you're going to need to do is create freedom for yourself, right? Once you have the systems in place, once you have the processes in place, now you need to be able to kind of step away, learn to delegate and get the right people in place to run those systems, all right? Which is totally different than let me go find the right person to run my company. You just need them to run the systems. The systems are running the business. And see, a lot of people try to go and scale and try to grow their company, but they don't have these things in place first, right? They don't have their blueprint in place of exactly what that means for them. And it's different for everybody. They don't have their systems in writing to where the systems are running the business, and then they get people to run the systems. Then they don't create that space of freedom for themselves to be able to step away, know that everything's running good based on the systems and the processes and the people that they've put in place and their delegation and ability to delegate and feel confident that things are getting done correctly. And now they can work on business development. At that point, you could scale. At that point, you can grow, right? And to do it before then, you're either going to hit a wall and stumble, or you won't get as far as you could. You wouldn't get as far as your potential would allow you to get if you kind of laid these things out.